Good evening. There were tears of anger in the Supreme Court as Bourke Street killer James Gargasoulas was sentenced to life in prison, but given the chance to one day walk free. The judge told the mass murderer he had to be appropriately punished for his cowardly and callous crime. Court reporter Eliza Rugg was there.
He'll serve six life sentences for what a Supreme Court judge said was one of the worst examples of mass murder in Australian history. But James Gargasoulas has been given a glimmer of hope. After 46 years, he could one day walk free.
There is no excuse for murder. If you are a danger to society, you should never be allowed to roam free. This sentence is not harsh enough.
After almost stabbing his brother to death on January 20, 2017, the now 29-year-old was behind the wheel of a stolen car being chased by police through Melbourne. In a drug-induced psychosis, he drove onto the footpath of the Bourke Street Mall, deliberately mowing down innocent pedestrians. Six people were killed, including two children. Zachary Bryant was the youngest at 3 months old. His pram remained lodged in the car's windscreen as police tasered Gargasoulas to end the massacre. 27 others were injured. Many are still unable to walk. Others have permanent brain damage. One could not but be profoundly moved by the terrible devastation that you, by your actions, brought about that day. During his trial, the killer claimed that he was the real victim of government oppression. And although he was sorry, he was acting on a premonition, telling him to run people down. Justice Weinberg branded him a coward with no genuine remorse. I'm convinced, and so was the jury, that you knew full well what you were doing. Gargasoulas was flanked by four prison guards as he sat in the dock. Like almost all of his other court appearances, he showed little reaction and stared blankly ahead. Despite his extensive criminal history, the judge ruled that he deserved a shot at parole, in part because of his relatively young age and also his deteriorating mental state, which would make a stint in prison tougher on him than other offenders. The father of five can apply for parole in his mid-70s.
Our family hopes that no one will ever have to suffer a similar fate as those who lost their loved ones and those who continue to struggle with survival.
Eliza Rugg joins me now. Eliza, will there be an appeal?
Well, Pete, the DPP hasn't indicated yet if it will appeal the sentence. The focus for the families now is on the coronial inquest. So that started in 2017 and it will resume at some stage later this year. That will look at the actions of police and if anything could have been done to prevent the massacre. Now, looking forward for Gargasoulas, well, he'll remain in solitary confinement. He is in there for 23 hours of the day. And as we've heard, Pete, it will be up to a future parole board to decide if he can ever be set free.
Okay, thank you, Eliza Rugg.